Hi, I am Dr. Suresh Shanai, working as Associate Professor in KMC Hospital, B.R. Ambedkar Circle. Today, I am going to talk to you regarding a common disease called gastroesophageal reflux disease. What exactly this GERD or gastroesophageal reflux disease means? It's nothing but you have a reflux of either a acid or a bile or acidic material coming into the esophagus. And here, the patients usually come to you with the heartburn or retrosternal burning along with the regurgitation of the food also coming into your mouth. And this is a common symptom what we come across in the OPD. If I see around 10 patients, 5 or 6 patients will be coming with these symptoms as such. Why is it common? Probably it may be because of the lifestyle changes commonly seen in obese people, or because of the change in the lifestyle modification. Most of them have a sedentary lifestyle now, or eating the junk foods, especially spicy food or oily food, taking more and more coffee, smoking or alcohol drinks. These patients usually have an increased risk of having a gastroesophageal reflux disease. So commonly they present with the retrosternal burning pain from here the throat up to the chest, or they can have a regurgitation of the food along with what we say water brush. When the acid comes up, because we have what salivary glands in the mouth, what has given us some natural protective mechanism to negate or neutralize the acid, the salivary gland secretes some of the juices, which is little bit of alkali. That's the reason you may get what known as water brush, salty taste in the mouth. These symptoms may be while taking the food or after the food, especially after a heavy fatty meal, or in the night when the patient goes to the sleep. Usually when the patient comes to these symptoms, we always have to look for whether it is really a GERD or it may be some other event. Especially a patient having hypertension or a diabetes, we always need to rule out what known as cardiac disease. Chest pain, always you need to rule out a heart problem, the myocardial infarction or an angina. So if the pain is bit of a severe and it increases on a walking, it's not a reflux disease, it may be related to the heart, where you need to look at consult a cardiologist immediately. There are atypical symptoms. Some of the patients may come with the recurrent episodes of ear and nose symptoms like a throat pain, hoarseness of the voice, or sometimes from the dental you may get a consultation telling the patient has a significant dental erosions as such, or you may get a consultation from a respiratory this one where the patient having a nocturnal cough, patient having a wheeze or recurrent aspiration pneumonia. These are some of the extra esophageal symptoms which may come across. This patient need to diagnose whether really the patient having a gastroesophageal reflux disease or some other complication. As I told you, patients who are obese or a pregnant lady taking much of a spicy food or irregular food habits, eating junk food, they are at a high risk. When the patient comes to you, we usually think that this may be a gastroesophageal reflux disease. Give a trial of what a proton pump inhibitor and observe for around 2 weeks. If they do not improve, or if there are any alarm symptoms, having a new onset of the retrosternal burning pain after around 50 years of age, or having a dysphagia. Dysphagia means having a difficulty in swallowing the food, maybe to the liquids or to the solid. Recent onset dysphagia or odynophagia, where patient have a pain while swallowing, which may be because of because of the medications also. Some of the medications called tetracycline or deriphyllin, some of the HIV medications can cause this type of symptoms, or recent weight loss, or having a vomiting of the blood, or having a black tar stool, what you know as melena, or a family history of a esophageal malignancy, having a cancer in the esophagus or the stomach. This type of patient say as a alarm symptoms. These patients need an immediate evaluation, then a trial of medications as such. Why this usually happen? Usually when we swallow the food, the lower esophageal sphincter, where the lower end of the esophagus, usually will relax and the food goes into the stomach. And that there may be mild, what known as transient lower esophageal relaxation as such, but some type of reflex, what we say the reflex usually happens. When it's really troublesome or is causing a symptom, then only we need to put them on the medications as such. Usually, when the food goes down into the stomach, much of the food does not come up or regurgitate. If there is a defect in the lower esophageal sphincter, which is usually formed by the muscles at the lower end of the esophagus and the, what is the crest of the diaphragm, or if there is any increase in the intra-abdominal pressure, which usually come in a patient with our intra-abdominal obesity or a pregnancy, or following some abdominal surgeries, or in the elderly, or the patient with the diabetes having gastroparesis, where there is delayed gastric emptying, this type of patient, or a patient having defect in the esophagus, where the peristalsis may be low, or there is a defect in the lower esophageal sphincter, or no, hiatus hernia, this type of patient are at the increased risk of developing a gastroesophageal reflux disease. How do you diagnose this gastroesophageal reflux? The purpose of the diagnosis is, if the patient does not improve with the trial of proton pump inhibitor or having an alarm symptom, mainly to look into what the severity of the disease. Sometimes doing an endoscopy may give a relief to the patient that he does not having a severe disease, or we may look into what the severity. We usually grade by the Los Angeles grading A, B, C, D. Look into what the severity and just decide how long the patient needs the treatment, or there may be complications of that. Of the gastroesophageal reflux disease, like a peptic stricture, where there will be narrowing into the lumen, causing a block to the flow of the food or the water as such, or a adenocarcinoma of the lower end of the esophagus or into the proximal stomach. So mainly to diagnose and to rule out any complication, we need to do a gastroscopy. If the patient does not respond to the usual trial of medication, or if does not have a severe disease, then in that case we may have to go for a esophageal manometer, high-resolution esophageal manometer, look into the mobility of the esophagus, are we dealing with some other complication, or a pH metry, mainly to see whether it's an acid or a bile which is causing the reflux. Mostly by change in the lifestyle modification, by doing the lifestyle modification, mainly taking small quantity of the food once in 2 to 3 hours, avoiding spicy and oily food, avoid bending immediately after taking the food, or while if you have the symptoms at night, usually lying down with the 2 pillows and avoiding carbonated food, avoiding coffee or increased coffee or alcohol, just with the medication, the symptoms can be subside. Symptoms do not subside. Sometimes if the patient is very obese, sometimes we may have to go for a bariatric surgery or a disopharyngoplication. These are some of the common symptoms of a gastroesophageal reflux disease.